Entertainment Tonight is next. Couldn't get within a mile of the post office at noon. Blame Elvis.
Think Ford first. Think number one.
Think Ford Escort, America's number one compact car with a special lease offer of just $199 a month. We're talking $199 a month for just 24 months on the Escort LX two-door, four-door, hatchback, or wagon. Every one comes loaded with air conditioning, AM/FM stereo, power steering, and more. It's your choice. Lease any Escort LX for just $199 a month.
Now through this Sunday, it's the JCPenney Red Tag Sale. Save 25, 30, even 50% store-wide. The JCPenney Red Tag Sale. Savings now through Sunday.
Rush Limbaugh, weekday mornings at 11, only on channels 5 and 30.
I got goosebumps and I was getting palpitations when it was coming close to 12 o'clock.
It was a Cinderella story of stamps, Elvis leaving the building in droves. Entertainment Tonight delivers for this Friday, January 8th, 1993.
Hello again, everybody. Thanks for joining us. I'm Mary Hart.
And I'm John Tesh. And after months of ballyhoo and build-up, the magic moment finally arrived. There was Elvis Presley's face looking young and trim as thousands lined up in the Memphis rain to give their stamp of approval.
Happy birthday, dear Elvis.
On what would have been Elvis's 58th birthday, there were fireworks sparkling, choirs singing, and about 5,000 fans braving 38-degree weather and a steady rain as stamps commemorating the king of rock and roll went on sale.
Yay, Elvis!
The king of rock and roll!
As the stroke of midnight approached and the official sales were set to begin, some lost track of how long they had waited in line.
Oh, Lordy, how many is that? Eight and a half hours.
I got goosebumps and I was getting palpitations when it was coming close to 12 o'clock, like it was New Year's Eve or something, you know, and here you are waiting for this big thing to happen, and then it happened, and it was so exciting.
At five special Graceland post offices, sales were nonstop. Some fans bought a few stamps.
I'd like 10 commemorative stamps.
Other fanatics bought thousands.
About $2,600 worth, 9,000.
The post office presented special commemorative stamps to Priscilla Presley, and in her first public appearance at Graceland, Elvis's press-shy daughter Lisa Marie expressed her thanks for the honor.
It's a great acknowledgement, and I really appreciate it, and I speak on behalf of him and my family and myself. Thank you.
Within hours, the frenzy that gripped Graceland spread across the country.
You ain't nothing but a hound dog.
In Washington, D.C., there were more stamps, more fans, and in New York City, the crowd counted down as sales began at noon. As postal workers filled order after order, the image of the young Elvis gyrated in their minds.
Hey, we love that gyrating pelvis. That's Elvis.
If the 300 million first printing of Elvis stamps sells out, do not worry. A backup order of 200 million more is in the works.
Colonel Tom Parker got into show business as a traveling man, the owner of the Great Parker Pony Circus, and Colonel Tom Parker and his dancing chickens. But his biggest claim to fame by far was when he became Elvis Presley's manager in return for 25% of the take.
You got a manager, son?
Elvis, I'd like to introduce you to Colonel Tom Parker.
In Elvis and the Colonel, The Untold Story, Bo Bridges stars as Colonel Tom Parker and Rob Youngblood as Presley. Parker managed Elvis from 1956 until Elvis's death in 1977, when the Colonel had increased his take to half of every dollar Elvis earned. However, Bridges says their relationship was more like father and son.
They really depended on one another. And like any loving relationship that goes through a long period of time, there's a lot of ups and downs. There's a lot of mistakes.
Elvis, is it true the Colonel runs your life? Nobody runs Elvis's life but Elvis!
Parker never allowed Elvis to perform outside the U.S. The Colonel is also blamed for selling out Elvis's acting career in B-movies.
I think his idea was that Elvis should not overextend himself and try things that he couldn't pull off, and for that reason he turned down movies like West Side Story and so forth. But then who's to say whether maybe if Elvis had done that, he wouldn't have done such a great job. I mean, we'll never know.
How come you turned down A Star Is Born?
Well, you want to play some washed-up singer and second build a Streisand besides?
Well, instead of a lounge act in Vegas?
You tour?
However, Bridges says Parker should deserve credit for discovering Elvis and turning him into a superstar.
I was a teenager in the late 50s and was not a huge Elvis fan, so I didn't really care for him too much. And so I would be more supportive of the fact that the Colonel had an awful lot to do with his meteoric rise to fame.
It's you and me, just like always. Elvis and the Colonel up against the world!
Elvis and the Colonel, The Untold Story, airs Sunday night on NBC.
One night, Elvis was up all night partying in Memphis, and he decided on the spur of the moment, hey, let's zip up to Washington, D.C. and meet President Nixon. The lowdown is they were to become fast friends. Elvis, a bookworm? At his buddy Richard Nixon's library, he is considered the king, especially this weekend. The lowdown is that in honor of his birthday today and Nixon's tomorrow, the admission price of $4.95 will be waived. The former president found Presley shy, but even Mr. Nixon isn't above a little Elvis exploitation. The library will offer commemorative cards with the new Elvis 29-cent stamp for $3 a pop.
Profit can be made on presidents as well, and it seems everyone's trying to cash in on Bill Clinton these days. After the president-elect ordered a moose head in a Santa Barbara bar, the company put this ad to print playing off Clinton's past. The lowdown is, Moosehead hopes to become the official beer of the White House, helping to prove he didn't avoid the draft.
And sorry, Mrs. Clinton, but no one is immune when it comes to capitalism. Spy magazine hopes to sell lots of magazines with this cover, spoofing Hillary's power in the White House. Editor Kurt Anderson says they pasted her face on the body of a leather-clad model to prove a point.
Well, that she is a powerful, forthright, new age sort of woman, and we depicted her, we sort of took that idea to an extreme.
And Patsy Pease is a woman with many extremes in her life. The soap star had a hidden past of child abuse that she couldn't shake, and it cost her her job.
I didn't mind being fired so much as I minded not one note of hope you feel better.
The private struggles of a star trying to shed her past, coming up next.
During the Roman era, 28 was considered old.
In the 1800s, 60 was over the hill.
You got it!
Next on E.T., it's a political thriller with a sexual charge. We'll show you why everybody's talking about the crying game.
Thank you. To all of you attracted by Buick's reputation for quality, but who think a new Buick is beyond your means, may I make the following suggestion? Go see the new Buick Skylark Custom. It is every bit a quality Buick. And as the most affordable Buick for 1993, it makes Buick quality more attractive than ever.
Hit the road, Jack, and don't you come back no more.
What you say?
Hit the road, Jack.
We've got him! Quacked up! Absolutely crazy!
Fillon's used car locations join forces for a giant used car crazy sale. The state's largest selection. Over 500 marked with absolutely crazy prices. Many under $3,000 with a special group under $1,000 like an 80 Honda wagon or a 79 Dodge pickup plus drawings for several $10 cars. $10. That's not a mistake.
We're just crazy.
First come, first serve.
You know while they last.
At all Fillon used car locations.
This week, Russ Beeler's in-laws came to Lake Edna, and how better to feed a group like this than the KFC Super Value Buckets? 15 pieces of the Colonel's original recipe, just $9.99, and super-sized buckets of zesty hot wing pieces, also $9.99. Super Value Buckets are here for a limited time.
And thankfully, so are my in-laws.
The KFC Super Value Buckets.
We are KFC, we do chicken right.
Every holiday season, audiences hungry for movies turn the big star films into big hits. But this year, a little movie called The Crying Game arrived without much hype, and now everybody is talking about this story of sex, terrorism, and honor. This hard-to-define film stars Forrest Whitaker as a British soldier taken hostage by the Irish Republican Army.
You won't run.
What if I did? You wouldn't shoot a brother in the back.
Johnny!
and desperately wants to survive. And he doesn't believe in any way, shape, or form that they're not going to kill him. And the only way that he can is by making some link with this one person whom he thinks might be open to stopping his execution.
That one person is Irish actor Stephen Ray, who plays one of the terrorists.
I'm glad you're doing it. Do you know that, Fergus?
Why?
Because you're my friend.
The real intrigue begins when Forrest asks his sympathetic captor to visit his girlfriend.
Take out my wallet. I want you to do something for me.
I want you to find her out. Tell her I was thinking of her.
Ray looks her up in London and falls in love, but his old IRA colleague Miranda Richardson tracks him down. Suddenly, he's torn between romance and his former terrorist ways.
I would call it a romantic film. I think it's about love as much as anything else.
See that, Carl?
See what, Neil?
You gave me a look.
Critics are raving about the bewitching performance of newcomer Jay Davidson, but Miranda Richardson is praising The Crying Game's director, Neil Jordan.
His films are like going to a carnival. They're wonderful. They're really rich.
So what do you think?
Kind of suicide, isn't it? But Dan, I don't have a choice.
Film production in the British Isles has been extremely sluggish, but leading man Ray says both cast and crew had a feeling they were working on a quality project.
Everybody believed in the film, you know. And everybody, you know, from the focus pullers, you know, they all said, this is going to be great, you know. And there were a few movies happening in England or Ireland last year, so everybody was just glad to be in there on something that was this important.
USA Today says The Crying Game is a, quote, grade A sleeper that sends you out with an unexpected smile. The Crying Game is showing in most major cities right now.
In Scent of a Woman, Al Pacino plays a blind retired Army colonel who shows a young man how life should be lived. The way Al Pacino lives his life is private, but Leonard Maltin got him to open up in a rare interview.
Are you like a rich miser or something?
No, I'm just your average blind man.
Al Pacino has taken on many challenges in his career, but he's never played a blind man before. And as usual, he's completely convincing.
I found a way of defocusing so that the eyes are open. And because there was a question as to whether we would use contact lenses or not. And we decided against that. We thought it would be easier to just go and see where we went with just my eyes. And, you know, if you practice something and you keep at it, and you give it the time and the commitment, eventually it gets to be a part of you.
Does a character ever rub off on you? Does it take you time to shake a character when you're done, or could you just walk away?
I pretty much can walk away. Sure. I think it's after a while, after doing it this many years, I think you get to a point where it's acting.
Pacino has always tackled adult themes in his film. Scent of a Woman and his other current movie, Glengarry Glen Ross, are no exception.
Yes.
But I asked him if, now that he has a 3-year-old daughter, he'd do a more family-oriented type of picture.
A lot of my colleagues have done that. You see them popping up on children's shows and say, hey, I bet they just had a kid. I don't know. I do enough. I sort of like her to do stuff. That's, you know, let her be the it's her show.
As a father, I now have, my girl's now 6, so I've been going through what you're going through. And I found that it not only changed my life, but it changed the way I see a lot of things.
Oh, yeah, of course, sure. You say, gee, I'm not going to go through that red light. What would she think of me? How would it affect her? Yeah, you start thinking like that.
Pacino says he doesn't think he'll show his daughter Scent of a Woman or Glengarry Glen Ross just yet. But the buzz is he's going to be nominated for an Oscar for at least one of those films.
With what?
Leonard Maltin, Entertainment Tonight. Thank you, Leonard. Scent of a Woman opens across the country today. Later this year, Pacino will star in Carlito's Way, about a Puerto Rican gangster out of prison and trying desperately to go straight.
President-elect Bill Clinton will kick off tonight's 4th anniversary special edition of the Arsenio Hall Show, and that special leads off tonight's coming attractions.
Are we ready to get it on? Yeah!
Along with the president-elect's surprise appearance tonight, Arsenio marks a milestone with a look back at the stars he's interviewed over the last 4 years. Arsenio says he's grateful to his loyal fans.
Don't forget I'm the guy that they said wouldn't last 5 weeks, and I'm here going into year 5.
The Arsenio Hall Show airs tonight in syndication. Check local listings.
I say, you stop making excuses for him. You're always doing that.
Oh, you're hurting me. Oh.
Also on TV, Jameson Parker stars as an abusive husband who plots to kill his wife, played by Cheryl Ladd. The TV movie is based on a true story that Parker found intriguing.
As an actor, what fascinates me is what makes this man tick. Why is he the way he is?
Dead Before Dawn airs Sunday night on ABC.
I'm standing on the top of the world, at the North Pole.
On cable, comedian Michael Palin takes a serious look at trekking the globe in a new travel series. Palin says he's proud of covering 17 countries and more than 23,000 miles in 5 months.
I've stood on the North Pole, I've stood on the South Pole, I've crossed the Nubian Desert, I've seen the Victoria Falls. You know, I mean, not many people can say that.
Pole to Pole premieres Sunday night on A&E. And three golfers on the Ladies Professional Golf Association Tour are profiles in courage and dedication. Lisa Gibbons has more.
Emotional, touching stories. Golfers Heather Farr and Shelley Hamlin have faced cancer. Up-and-coming pro Kathy Gehring had her career derailed by a freak accident.
I truly thought that I was going to die.
Now these women will share the personal stories of their fights to survive. That's this weekend on Entertainment Tonight.
A mountain bike from Criterium Bike Shops will remind you why you live in Colorado. Discover how to see more of our region on a mountain bike fitted to your body, your riding style, and your budget with the help of Criterium's expert staff. Visit Criterium Bike Shops at 5660 North Academy or the new downtown location at 326 North Tejon to start your own off-road adventure. Criterium Bike Shops. Come test ride our shops.
Tired of tiny burgers and teeny tacos? Then start the new year with one of Arby's two meal deal specials. A delicious hot barbecue sandwich in tangy barbecue sauce, only $1.49 plus tax. Or buy any of Arby's big 6.5-inch subs with small curly fries and get a 32-ounce Pepsi free. If you're bored with burgers, don't miss Arby's New Year specials. Buy any barbecue sandwich, only $1.49 plus tax. Or any of Arby's big 6.5-inch subs with curly fries and get a 32-ounce Pepsi free.
The Carpet Exchange rolled out 7 million yards of carpet last year, enough to stretch clear across America. With that kind of volume, we can offer the biggest selection at the lowest prices. Like Monsanto wear-dated carpet, just $7.99. The Carpet Exchange, our prices will floor you.
Hi, this is Gary Brookshire for Home Furnishings Plus, and we've marked down every item in our entire showroom, no exceptions, during our January clearance sale.
Right now, these three-piece oak tables are just $93.99 for cocktail and two end tables. Or these solder desk, TV card, or entertainment centers are just $18.99 each. Plus 6 months free financing with no down payment.
Home Furnishings Plus. We simply sell for less.
Extra markdowns for a limited time only. Shop now for best selection.
Usually, shockproof soap opera fans are puzzled and angry at what happened to Patsy Pease of Days of Our Lives. Over Christmas, she was replaced as Kimberly Brady on the show shortly after her character had begun to have a mental breakdown. Now, Patsy tells us no soap writer could ever match the horror she experienced in real life. Here today is the inside story.
Papa, hi.
Kimberly, darling. Oh.
8 months ago, actress Patsy Pease made a triumphant return to Days of Our Lives. Pease had left the show, on which she had been a regular for 8.5 years, to enter a mental health facility to try and come to terms with her horrifying childhood.
I'm a survivor of ritual torture and have episodes of flashbacks. And Days has been aware of this ever since it started happening about 2 years ago.
Patsy had suppressed memories of her psychotic mother, whom she says physically, mentally, and sexually abused her during her childhood. But it wasn't until Patsy had married and had two children of her own that her painful past began to surface. She left her show and sought treatment and returned to Days of Our Lives 4 months later. Patsy says the producers were fully aware she still had problems to overcome.
They did permit me to come in instead of 6 o'clock in the morning, 8 o'clock. And that was a big plus, because usually my nights are spent talking half the night, screaming some parts of it, waking up different places in the house, not knowing how I got there.
Let's not kid ourselves, Shane. There are scars, and they deserve time to heal, so. so...
In spite of her continuing problems, Patsy continued to work. Ironically, her character on Days was given a multiple personality disorder. And Patsy says her bosses told her her work was Emmy caliber. But right before Thanksgiving, her flashback symptoms continued.
And I was doubled over in my dressing room. My husband was there. And I was breaking out, alternating hot and cold sweats, the spasms, uncontrollable crying. And my jaw wouldn't move. So, it became obvious to even my hard head that I was incapable of doing my job.
The producers of Days of Our Lives decided to replace Patsy and have another actress continue in her role. Patsy says the love and support of her husband, Robert, and their two children has helped her get through the disappointment of it all.
I didn't mind being fired so much as I minded not one note of hope you feel better. Are you okay?
Patsy admits she's still trying to recover from the abuse she suffered at the hands of her mother. And right now, she's not thinking about resuming her career. But Robert says, do not count Patsy out.
Most people who go through these kind of things don't survive. And I'm amazed that not only has she survived, but she's dealt with all of this stuff and has come through stronger and continues to come through stronger all the time.
We contacted both NBC and Days of Our Lives, and neither had any comment about Patsy Pease's dismissal.
Patrick Swayze danced his way into one of America's hottest hangouts, but he had to leave his shoes at the door. Patrick Swayze with his wife Lisa Mimi donated the shoes he wore in Dirty Dancing to the Planet Hollywood in Santa Ana, California. But Swayze said the shoes were tough to part with.
Well, Dirty Dancing meant so much to me, and it blew the lid off my life, and put a lot of blood, sweat, and tears, you know, into making the film in these shoes.
In London, singer Tom Jones opened the huge After Christmas sale at Harrods with store chairman Mohammed Al-Fayed. The event raised money for a children's charity, and Jones says he was glad to help.
I think it's great. I think it's that everybody benefits from it, so it's a good thing.
And in New York, dozens of little girls sang their way through auditions for the Broadway musical Annie Warbucks. Among those dreaming of playing Annie was Samantha Wilde.
It would be fun, and people would just say, "Hey, there's Samantha Wilde. Can I have your autograph?" Or something like that.
47 people have the chance to drive an exclusive
white
ESS Escort.
ESS Ranger.
47 limited editions just arrived.
All just $177 a month.
Escort, America's bestseller.
Ranger, all new for $93, just $177 a month.
White.
All new cars and trucks, no payments till July. Yes, July.
White.
Even 500 used to choose from.
Why drive ordinary?
47 limited editions, $177 a month.
When they're gone, they're gone.
Exclusively at Phil Long Ford, the value store.
It's time for the annual inventory reduction sale at the Carpet Mill Outlet Store. We need to make room for our spring lineup, and that means we're offering sensational deals, like no payments until July 1993, with no interest and no money down. But hurry, with financing like this available, selections will be moving fast. The inventory reduction sale on now at the Carpet Mill Outlet Store, I-25 and Garden of the Gods behind McDonald's.
The Carpet Mill Outlet Store, we've got the touch.
Wrongs is just a drugstore, right?
Wrong. Wrongs is romance. Wrongs is clean. And neat. Wrongs is adventure and fashion. Wrongs is people, helping people, offering delivery of pharmaceuticals. And of course, Wrongs is great prices on all the big names, in every aisle. So, Wrongs is just a drugstore?
Wrong. It's the best drugstore in town.
Hi, Mary. We're running right on schedule. So confirm our 3 o'clock with Emerson, our 4 o'clock with Moore, and our 5 o'clock with Sherman. Whoa, Mary, we just hit one heck of a traffic jam. Better postpone our 3 o'clock to 4 o'clock. Or 4
Introducing
o'clock
to 5 the new Steak Lovers Pizza from Pizza Hut. Special sauce, delicious steak, onions, and three kinds of cheese.
We shouldn't be doing this.
Hey, guys, sometimes you gotta stop and smell the pizza.
Air travel furnished by and a promotional fee paid by Delta Airlines. Delta can now fly you to more cities across the Atlantic than any other U.S. airline. At Delta, we love to fly, and it shows.
You know I can't.
divin. C'est pour moi l'on.
Celebrating a birthday today, actress Jenny Lewis is 17, singer David Bowie, 46, singer Shirley Bassey, 56 today, comedian Soupy Sales turned 67, comedian Larry Storch is 70, actress Butterfly McQueen is 82, and if Elvis is out there, he's 58.
If, he says? She's the hottest star in the world and says the only thing bigger than her fame is her mouth. Every time she opens it, Madonna finds herself right in the middle of trouble.
There's a lot of people who would think that every time I open my mouth, I make a mistake. So every breath I take is a mistake.
She's the world's most controversial woman.
Well, no risk, no glory.
But she's still a woman who's more than just a series of sexy images.
I have, like, fantasies about being a housewife in suburbia. Because to me, that is so exotic. You know, it's like the North Pole, you know.
Madonna, whose videos have been banned, whose book has been banned, and whose new movie is rated H for hot, 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 is a woman with a message.
The more people say, sex is bad, sex is bad, sex is bad, the more I want to say, no, it's not, no, it's not, no, it's not.
A rare and candid interview with Madonna, our inside story Monday on Entertainment Tonight. If she were a suburban housewife, suburbia obviously would have undergone a revolutionary change.
Elvis, if you are out there, buddy, happy birthday, mama baby. We're going to close out the week with memories of Elvis. Enjoy it, and we will see you Monday.
Go buy those stamps, folks.
Between the pages of my mind, memories sweeten through the ages just like wine. Quiet thoughts come floating down and settle softly to the ground like gold of autumn leaves around my feet. I touch them and they burst apart with sweet memories. Sweet memories of holding hands and red bouquets and twilights trimmed in purple haze and laughing eyes and simple ways and quiet nights and gentle days with you. Memories press between the pages of my mind. Memories sweeten through the ages just like wine. Memories, memories. Of holding hands and red bouquets and twilights trimmed in purple haze and laughing eyes and simple ways and quiet nights and gentle days with you. Memories, memories.
Thank you. You're beautiful. Thank you very much.